Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to talk about using columns in Excel. So first of all, we are going to talk about different functions that you can perform inside of a column in Excel. We want to be able to find duplicate values inside of a column and then automatically remove those duplicates. Next, we are going to talk about how to separate one column into two separate columns. And then finally, we are going to learn how to parse together two columns back into one column inside of our spreadsheet. So let's look at the Excel spreadsheet that we're going to start using for today. I have a spreadsheet of names. And as you can see here, I have the first name, a space, and then the last name. I have chosen some of the most common first and last names to use in this. And so the first thing I would like to do is to look into column B and see if I have any duplicate data in here. First of all, I'm going to highlight column B, and then I'm going to go up to Home, and I'm going to go over here to Conditional Formatting, and then I'm going to hit Highlight Cell Rules, and then I'm going to look for duplicate values. This box is asking me what color I would like those duplicate values to be. It doesn't really matter because I'm only going to use this for a minute, so I'm just going to go with the default and click OK. So when I look over here to the left, I can see that Riley Lee is appearing twice in here, and so is Scarlett Allen. I can also see that I have 58 rows of data. So I now know that I have two duplicates and 58 rows. Next, if I go up to the data ribbon and I go over here to remove duplicates, I can click that button and I will be asked the question first, do I want to expand this selection to include other columns of data or do I just want to continue with what I've selected? I'm going to click continue with the current selection. Next, I'm going to click this button that says remove duplicates. I will be asked which column I am wanting to remove my duplicates from. Do you see over here where it says my data has headers? And down here where it says the name of my columns is name, that is coming from over here in cell B1 with this column header that says name. That is the correct column that I wish to remove my duplicates. So I'm going to click OK, and I will be notified that two duplicate values are going to be found and removed, and I will be left with 55 unique values. I'm going to click OK and keep your eye over here on that conditional formatting, and you will see now that it goes away. So I now only have one instance of Riley Lee, and I now only have one instance of Scarlett Allen. And if I scroll all the way down, I no longer am at row 58. I'm at row 56. And remember, I have 55 left, but why am I on row 56? That's because when I scroll up here, the name of this column is taking up one of my cells. So 56 minus 1 is the 55 records that were remaining that last dialog box was asking me about. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. Next, I can separate the information in this name column into two different columns. If you look here, there might be a time when I would like the first name in one column and the last name in a second column. So how do I go about doing that? Well, first, I want to highlight the column that I want to split, and I'm going to go up to the data ribbon and go over here to this option that says text to columns. When I click on that, I'm going to be asked a series of questions. The first question I'm being asked is, how am I splitting my data? How do I know which data goes in the first column and which data should go in the second column? Well, I have something in this case called a delimiter. A delimiter is a common character that is found in every single one of my rows. In this case, I have a space in between the first name and the last name, and I really want Excel just to look for that space and then divide up that information into two different columns. Another option that you can sometimes have is this one right here. It's called fixed width. That would mean that every five characters, I want to put what's to the left of those five characters in one column and what's to the right of those five characters into another column. But that is not the case here. The case that we have here is we actually do have a delimiter. That's the space. So I'm going to click on next. And I can see here that space has been selected as my delimiter. If I uncheck that box and I pick anything else, you will see down below that my data is not separating correctly. But as soon as I uncheck the other delimiters and I put space again, you can get a preview of how my data is going to be split. And that is correct. So if I go down here and click next, I am now being asked, first of all, what kind of data is this? I want to select the text option because that's the kind of data I have because it's a name. And then down here where it says destination, where would I like to split this data? Right now it's going to split in column B, but all my original data is in column B. I really don't want that to happen. I would really like it to start at column C. So I'm going to highlight the B and make it say C. And then I'm going to click finish. I am now being notified that data already exists there. And that is true. And do I want to replace it? Yes, I do. And it's true because it's sensing the data right here in the column headers for C and D for first name and last name. That's because I highlighted B1 with the word name in it. And it is going to just replace my headers initially, but that's okay because I can just go back and fix them. So I'm going to say okay. And if you look over here, you will see that the first names have gone into column C and the last names have gone into column D. But if I look down here, I can see that some of my formatting's off. So I'm going to highlight both columns, go up to home, and just left justify those. And up here, I'm going to make this column called first name and this column called last name. And it's as simple as that. I've now split one column into two separate columns. But what if you had the exact opposite scenario, where you had a first name column and a last name column, and you actually wanted those two columns to be put together, or what we call in the programming world, parsed together into one column. I could click on cell E2, and it's a pretty quick function. You can type equals, which cell do I want to come in there first? I want the first name, so I'm going to click on C2, and then I'm going to put an ampersand. And I'm going to put a space inside double quotes so that I can put a space between my first name and my last name. Then I'm going to put another ampersand, and then I'm going to click on last name. So let's review that formula one more time. Every time I put in an ampersand, I'm joining text together. So what I want to join together here is C2, which is first name, and then a space, and then what's in D2, which is last name. So first name, space, last name. If I hit enter, you will see that that did parse those two columns together correctly. If I want to autofill all of that to the end of my data set, I'm going to click on E2 and then just double click over here in the bottom right hand corner where I see that square. And you can see that all of my cells have now been populated once again with the actual name of the person. So in review, when dealing with some columns in Excel, there's a couple different options that you have. There are different ways to find duplicate data, and then you can easily remove duplicate data. We also looked at a way to separate one column of data into two separate columns using a delimiter. And then we finally looked at how to parse together two columns into one column once again. Hopefully you learned something new today. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below or leave a request for a video that you would like to see in the future. Looking forward to seeing you again next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.